Hello friends, welcome to the mindtouchtech YouTube channel. My name is Prince and this is our fifth JavaScript lecture, and in this lecture we will study about the data types in JavaScript. That what are data types, how many types of data types we have in the JavaScript, and how to use the data types in the JavaScript. So let us start friends. So first of all friends, we have to know about that what are these data types. So friends, data types are the types of the data in the JavaScript. You can see that there are so many types of the, there are so many data in the JavaScript, and you can give them data a type, and this is known as the data types. And in other words, you can see that data types are the classifications of the data. And in JavaScript, we have string data type, number data type, boolean data type, array data type, object data types, and also null and undefined are also the data type friends. And in this lecture, we will only study about the string, number, boolean, and also null and undefined data types. In our upcoming lectures, we will also study about the array and the object data types in the deep, because these are the important concepts, friends. We will discuss these data types in our upcoming lectures, so that you can understand better about the array and the object. So let us study about first the string data type. So let us first of all, I have to open the Sublime text editor. So open the Sublime text editor. What I did here, I have write here the body structure of the HTML, and also I have created an external JavaScript file, and I have linked that external JavaScript file between that script tag. You can see here that I have linked that external file, that is JavaScript file, to that, to here friends. Okay friends, so let us start friends, let us start about the string data types. So friends, string are the data types which we, so what is string? String is that the words or the sentence or anything that we put between the double quotes or in the single quotes is known as the string data types. So write the string data type, we have to write here the variable and then give here name is equals to in double quotes. In double quotes we have to give here the value, that is Prince. Now this is what? This is a string, that is in the double quotes, anything between that double quotes is a string phrase. Okay, so it is a string data type, name is a string data type phrase. This is a variable of data type, that is string. And also in the JavaScript, if you write here that single quotes, then JavaScript will also consider that it is a string. But generally, the single quotes is for the character. But in the JavaScript, consider that it is also a string, friends. Okay, so don't worry. So it is not be confusing that character, double quotes and the single quotes. You can write here the single quotes or the double quotes. Okay, friends. So this is a string, friends. Now, let us print that message. That is alert. I'm going to write here the alert method. Alert and then print call that is variable name. You can see here that I have called that variable to that function, to that method friends, that is name. And now control plus s, and also here control plus s. Now you can see the desktop that friends, our two files has been made. Our first is our external file and second is our data type file. Okay friends, that is the HTML file. Now double click on that. Now you can see here that it is giving us the result, that is Prince. Okay, this is a string friends, this is a string data type friends. And also you can write here like that in the, if you write here in the single quotes, then JavaScript will consider that it is also a string. Control plus s and then control plus r, you can see that it is still working friends, it is giving us the value, that is the Prince friends. So this is about the string data type friends. And also if you want to, you can use here the to show you the type of that, you can use here the keyword, that is the type of keyword. What does this type of keyword means? This type of keyword will show you the type of that data, that is the type of that data which you have given here. And this type of keyword will show you the data type. Now control plus s, and you can see control plus r, you can see that it is giving is the its type, that is string, that is the Prince is a string data type friends. So type of keyword is used to show you the type of the data friends. So this is about that friends. Now let us study about the number data type friends. Okay, so for that what you have to do, you have to write here like that, let it like sum is equals to 2 plus 5. So what is this? This is the number data type friends. Okay, and you can write here, you can write here that double quotes. If you write here the between, put that number 5 between the double quotes, then the JavaScript consider that it is a string, it is not a number. So number, we have to remove that double quotes, that is the double quotes. Now control plus s and then control plus r, you can see here again I have to save it, I have to give here the name, that is sum. What I have to do, I have to call that sum to that. The control plus S and then of control plus R, you can see here that it is showing is the its data type, that is, it is a number data type, friends. So it's about that, friends. Okay, friends. So this is about that. And also, if I remove that, it will print the sum of these two numbers, control S and then now control plus R. Now you can see that it is giving you the result, that is 2 plus 5 is 7, friends. And one concept has to be noticed here, friends. Focus on that. I'm telling you the difference between the string and the numbers. Focus on that, friends. Like, if I put that number between the double quotes, friends, like that. The control plus S, it will not add. It will not add 2 plus 7. It will not give the result 7. But it will give the result, that is 25, friends. Because we have put that 5 between these double quotes, friends. And it will consider the JavaScript, will consider that it is a string. Control plus R, S, and then control plus R. You can see here that it is giving the result, that is the 25. It is not adding that. Because we have given that the string data type, friends. Okay, now let us create another thing, that 2 plus 5 plus 9. Okay, 2 plus 5 plus 9, control S, control R. It is giving the result, that is 16, friends. Okay, and if I change like that, if I put that it in the double quotes 9, then it will what? It will first add the first two number, that is 5 plus 2, that is 7, and it will not add 9. Why? Because we have put that between the double quotes, and the JavaScript consider that it is a string, friends. It will not add that. So it will give the result, that is the 79. Now control plus S and then now control plus R. Now you can see here that it is giving the result 79. It is not adding the 9. Okay, this is about that. And instead of writing that double quotes here, if you write the double quotes like here, double quotes and the double quotes, and what does it mean? It will also not add 5 plus 9. It will consider whole the numbers as a string. Control plus S. Control plus R. It will not add, that is 259. You can see here that, friends, 259. It is considered the whole numbers as a string. So this is the difference. This is the basic or little to little concept that you have to know about the string and the numbers, friends. So this is about that data type, friends. Okay. Now let us discuss about the Boolean data types. What does this Boolean data types mean? Booleans are the data types which gives you the value either in the form of true or either in the form of false. Like if you write here true, then it is a Boolean data type, friends. Okay, if you write here false, or also this is a Boolean data type, friends. Now control plus S. Now let us write here the type of, to show you that this is a type of sum, control plus S, and then of control plus R. Now you can see here that it is showing us the message that it is a Boolean data type, friends. So this is about that. And also, if you give here the value that is the false, and it is also a Boolean data type, friends. Wait for a while. Boolean data type, friends. Control R, Boolean data type, friends. It is also showing here, right? So this is about that, friends. Okay, now if I didn't give initialize that value like that, if I didn't initialize that, then what it will give? Control plus S and then control plus R. Now you can say that it is giving us the undefined. Okay, so it is a undefined data type, friends, because we didn't initialize that to any data type, friends. Okay, friends. And also, if you initialize to it null, that is null. Okay, now control plus S and then now control plus R, you can see here that it is giving us the result, that is the object. So it is the object data type, friends. Okay, why object data type? Because we have given this a null. Null means nothing. Null means nothing, that it doesn't have any, it is not initialized to nothing. That is null. It doesn't have any value. Okay, friends. And if we didn't write here anything, then it will consider that it is undefined. We didn't define here. We didn't assign any value here. So friends, this is about the data types in the JavaScript. In our next lecture, we will study about the prompt box in JavaScript, that how to take the value from the user. So this is about that. So if you like my video, then subscribe my channel, share my channel, and also press the bell icon so that the notification of my all the new videos will show to the notification bar of your mobile source. So thank you for watching, dear friends. Take care. Bye bye.